one beautiful research. In the research, what they did, actually, to think itself that person should be a spiritual person. The research which we are going to explain now, to think that research, the researcher should be a spiritual person. Such a wonderful research he did. He took the cell in a operating media. From that operating media, he took the DNA and kept it. Now the DNA is kept outside the body. From a person's body, he took a cell. From that cell, he took a DNA. Because the DNA is the thing which releases the hormones and everything. It only prepares. It only prepares and releases the hormone. He took the DNA segment where it is existing. He took the whole DNA segment. And he kept the DNA segment in an outer media. It is not having any connection with the body directly. Even the electrode connection is not there. Outside the body, he kept. He kept and he analyzed the body's and the person's hormone. How, what all the hormones are released in that particular time. And he checked the DNA. The DNA also releasing the same hormones. This happened first time. Then he made the person to go into anger. The DNA also releasing the anger. But the DNA is not inside the body. Understand the fact that DNA is not inside the body. The DNA is in the outside of the body. It is in the outside of the body. It is releasing the same anger energy. And he went into fantasy. Again, the DNA released the fantasy-related hormones. Again, he was frightened by the research group. For the research purpose, he was frightened. When he got frightened, the DNA also released the fear hormones. After the initial test is over, he took the medium 10 feet away. Again he tested, same result. Then he took 20 feet, same result. Then he took 100 feet, same result. Up to 1.5 miles, up to 1.5 miles he took, the same result was existing. The DNA was reproducing the same hormonal replay again and again. By this research, one important conclusion was revived. The time and distance is not existing between the DNA and him. Even the DNA is kept such a difference, such a distance. The second he goes into anger, the DNA also goes into anger. The second he goes into the fear, the DNA also fears. That means the subtle connection is there. Even the DNA was there. The subtle connection was there. This miraculous phenomena is existing even in an ordinary man. In an ordinary man can exhibit this much energy means, think about the master. Think about the master who got enlightened. His energy expression and he radiating the energy can act in the same way. Each and everybody of you can not behave like you can be Nityananda. The DNA which was kept 1.5 miles away from that person was acting as a representative until that has life. Until that DNA has life, it behaved in the same way. It releases the same chemicals and hormones. If an ordinary person's DNA can do this thing, his DNA, Ananda Ganda, is inside of everybody of us. That one DNA is enough. God's DNA is Ananda Ganda. That DNA is enough to put you in bliss, to put you in enlightenment, and to radiate his quality, radiate his nature, and become him. Actually, you are him. Somehow we are not allowing that self. Actually, each and everybody of you got the initiation. You are him. No way, no change. You are him. There is no alteration. But somehow the so-called ego, the self doesn't have that much ego. The self doesn't have. But this self, a collection of self, and one doctor calls our body as a, with a good word, Actually, even a small cell has the same intelligence what we have. It also does all the functions. Your respiration, your blood circulation, your thinking, your nervous system action, bone action, and reproduction, everything. What are all the nonsense you do? A single cell does. And it manages itself. It doesn't go to the court and apply for divorce and all. It doesn't have any problem with the neighbors. It perfectly runs. What are all the things you do, the single cell also doing. And you are nothing but collection of millions of cells, that's all. An amoeba or a collection of amoeba, that's all the difference. If a small cell is taken away from you and it is called as amoeba conscious. And if you are collection of amoeba, you will call us amoebic conscious, that's all. Our whole body is nothing but amoebic conscious. Lot of cells together and they assembled for a good purpose and they are running the whole issue. And in the very combination, somewhere the illusionary phenomena, ego is existing. The illusionary phenomena is like the darkness which is existing. You can't trace the darkness, you can't catch the darkness, you can't photograph the darkness, nothing you can do. With the darkness, you can't cut the darkness, you can't erase the darkness, you can't eat the darkness, nothing you can do, but the darkness will be existing until the light is coming. The moment the light comes, the darkness will not be there at all. In the same way, in our inner space, the darkness, ego is existing. It's pure illusionary. The moment the light goes there, it will not be there. Otherwise, it will be there. Even for 1,000 years, even for crores to other years. Or even for some countless yugas. How many yugas the darkness will be there? Until the light comes, it will stay there comfortably. It will stay there as a very solid existence. But it is a pseudo existence. Light is a solid existence. But in the light, you can see everything. But in the darkness, you can't see anything. That is the major disadvantage of the illusion. In the same way, in the inner world, we have that negative illusionary phenomena called ego, which is the darkness of our inner space. In our inner space, the light is not there so far until the Ananda Diksha is initiated. We didn't have that light. The moment we got the Ananda Diksha, the light was lighted and the flames are there. Now what we have to do? We have to expand the light. We have to expand the, we have to spread that light. As I know, it's like one candle. If the area is some 10 acre, 20 acre, a small candle, what it can do? Nothing it can do. Maximum, it can help you in day-to-day affairs, that's all. Moving from here and there, it will help you, that's all. For the whole area, you need bigger light, you need big flame. The Ananda Ganda, which we got, the Ananda flame, which is in our inner space, it has to burn a lot. It has to expand a lot. Once it getting expanded, once the conscious flame is expanded, once the width of the flame is expanded, the darkness cannot stand. Until then, whatever you do, the darkness will be there. So living in Ananda Ganda is the ultimate solution and it's a must for the life. It's not option. You come and attend Ananda Spurana program and you can go. You can come and attend the NSP, whether you can work on the engram or don't work on the engram, no problem. You can go and run your life. But living in Ananda Ganda is not optional. It's a compulsion. It is the compulsion for each and every healer. There is no option for you. If you are a healer, you have to live in Ananda Ganda. If you are not living in Ananda Ganda, means you and the person who are running outside are one and the same. You are having the diamond in the locker and the person don't have the diamond. What is the difference? No use. Maximum you can have one thought, I have diamond. With the diamond, no value because it is in the locker. Even a stone is there, that also has the same value. So we have Ananda Ganda Diksha and the people don't have Ananda Ganda Diksha. That's the only thought we have, that's the only difference we have. Nothing else. We are not living in Ananda Ganda. Until you start living in Ananda Ganda, we are not even healers. We are some dealers, that's all. We have some dealing with Nityananda, not healing. We have some dealing. Because he gave the pure sensation, because of the dealing, we do healing for half an hour per day, that's all. You have to do half an hour, healing half an hour every day is the dealing he put for you. You know clearly. You know who kind, what kind of people you are, you know. Because he knows clearly, he put the dealing. You want healing, have a dealing. Half an hour, you have to do Ananda Diksha, and at least you have to attend 2-3 patients. You have to do this, then it's perfectly okay. At least in a day, part-time we are healers. All are part-time healers only. No full-time healers, only full-time healer is there. That's all. All are part-time healers. So he wants us to become a full-time healers. He wants no dealing from us. He wants healing from us. He wants you to become him. He don't want you to worship him. He wants you to become him. He tells you also can become like me. You also can become me. For that, he is not just giving the inspiration. He gave the technique, he gave the room, he gave the map, everything. Racket, everything he gave. After giving everything, he is telling. Still, the fellow sitting there, not even moving and continuing the same length. How dare we do? Only God knows. Poor God. Compassionate God. He will give the realization. Let the people speak. How you can be blissful? How you can be blissful if you don't go to Ananda? How you can be blissful? Can you blister for yourself? But some of you run the life. Someone is going there. We are a candle. No problem will come. You know the map. Rest of the people don't have the map in the 100 acres of the inner space. Not even they have the candle. They have candle. But the candle is given to burn the whole area, burn the whole forest. The forest ready for the burning. Just if you light little grass, that's enough. If you light one grass or two grass, that's enough, the whole area will be burnt out. But we are not even building ever. That's the expression. We are not even working for that. Not even thinking about it. In the Ananda Ashtanga, Paramahansa tells, live in Ananda Ganda. But we are not living. So living in Ananda Ganda is not an option. It's not even a compulsion. It's an understanding. If you understand, it's an understanding. If you don't understand, it's a compulsion. It is a clear compulsion. If you understand, you will do with it a passion. You will be so excited to do it. In the world, nobody will be there who will hate honey. If at all a person is hating honey, if at all a person is not ready to lick honey, means he not even tasted the honey once in a life, that's all. There is nobody will be existing in the world to refuse to taste the honey. Our Ananda Ganda is much better than the honey. It's much better than the honey. So, the tasting the honey will start now, will start today. We'll lick once. This one day experience will give an opportunity for you to have a small lick. That one lick is enough. That will give the kick. You can't live. You can't live from that kick. In Tamil, we use it as mabbu. You can't live from the deva mabbu, deva sugam. Once Paramahamsa, according to you, what is bhakti? One of the brahmacharis told, bhakti is deva sugam. So bhakti is deva sugam means, how can it translate, I don't know. Deva sugam means is the
divine bliss.
It's not even divine bliss. It's, divine bliss is little traditional word. Deva sugam, how can it be translated? It's deva sugam. Some of you understood. Deva sugam. Because we know what is rajasugam. We know what is rajasugam. Having all the pleasures together. But deva sugam is little more higher than Devasubha. So this one day you will taste what is Devasubha, and it will put you in Devasubha. If you stay, if you taste the Devasubha, the beauty of Devasubha is you will become Deva. Deva means God. You will become Deva. The ecstasy and the bliss and the energy which God exists in, that is what Devasubha. Devasubha means the ecstasy, the bliss and the happiness and the joy, what the God is tasting. In that area where the God lives, that is what Devasubha. All of us will get Devasubha. If you get Devasubha, if you taste the Ananda Ganda, you will be in Bhakti. The rasa will be there. Bhakti rasa, the juice of the bhakti, the juice of the devotion will be there. And if you have bhakti, you will fall in Ananda Ganda. It's vice versa. Whenever you are in bhakti, you will fall in Ananda Ganda. If you feel, I am intellectual, I am not able to fall in bhakti, I am not able to raise in bhakti, whatever way you assemble the coin, the words. If you feel like I am not able to taste the bhakti, go to Ananda Ganda. You will come to bhakti. Because both are one and the same. If you go to bhakti, you will see you are already in Ananda Ganda. If you do, go to Ananda Ganda, you will see you are already in bhakti. Because both are one and the same. You will see and experience it. It's an experience. You can tell Nityananda experience. You can tell the zone of Nityananda, where Nityananda is living. Entering into the quarters where Swami is not entering into his zone. This is what entering into zone. Even if you had an opportunity to go and talk with him privately in the quarters, it is not a private time, it's a public time. Still it's a public time. Because you are inside your body and he is somewhere zone. You are inside your body. Even you are sleeping on his lap, you are publicly sleeping. It's not intimate moment. Even nobody is there in the stage. The screens are closed. Somehow you got the opportunity. You are having a very intimate time with the master. You are sleeping at his feet. Still you are sleeping in the public only. Because inside you hundreds of people are living. Still you are in the public. Until you go to the Ananda Ganda, you cannot call even a single intimate moment as an intimate moment. All moments are public moments. If you are able to sing to the Ananda Ganda, even the public, you are in his lap. Not even his lap, you are in his garbha. You are inside his garbha. Even little more than. You are inside his womb. You are part of his womb. Not even womb. The womb, the thing which creates the womb itself. You will go in such a deep, intimate place, you will be there. When you go into Ananda Ganda. When you don't go into Ananda Ganda, even if you are sleeping on the lap, nothing. Just, it's one more public moment. And once you taste this, once you taste this Ananda Ganda, once you experience how to do all the activities from Ananda Ganda, you also will start radiating his own qualities. Wherever you go, sit and raise, all the areas, his positive energy will ooze out. His bliss energy will ooze out from you. Recently, one more research we come across. What they did, the particle of light, I think everybody will know it's photon. If you divide each atom, the particle of the atom is electron. The ultimate part of the each atom is electron. Like that, the light rays are made up of photons. Like how the stone is made up of small stones. If you break a stone, it will become small stones. Like the same, too much of photons together forms the light rays. The scientists can take one photon separately. They can divide the light. So they divide the light in the empty vacuum area. They allowed a photon to live its life. They did it. Because by some other chemical arrangement and some other physiological mechanism, you can make the light to roam around in a small area. So they did it. They did it from the outside. We can watch and measure. what the photon is doing. We can watch. They watched. Once they watched, the photon is going on its own way. It was a random. The photon's movement was chaotic. It has no order. Suddenly going here and comes down and goes there, stands there, one rotation comes out. There is no clear pathway. The scientist is not, they are not able to gauge what the photon is doing, what the photon is thinking. They are not able to gauge. Because once it comes as a ray, it just comes and it follows the principles. It will come straightly only if the light rays are very obedient. They will come straight away and they have their own rules and regulations. If they have an object inside, they will bend themselves and they will go like this. They have certain rules and regulations. But this fellow who is inside the vacuum area doesn't follow any rules. He is so chaotic, he is running here and there, going whatever, what not jump, the photon is doing. And very intelligent approach they did. Again they caught the same photon and kept it another area. And they, in the open vacuum area, they put a DNA, a human DNA, put a human DNA. And then they put the photon inside and they locked the area. The result was amazing. The DNA started very simply and very circular manner, rotating around the DNA. Around the DNA, like how the planets is running around the sun, the single photon which was random few moments earlier started just coming around the DNA.